Hey guys, it's Andy. So I just got off the phone with the guy and he says, hey Andy, I had a customer ask me, what is my interest rate? And at that point, the salesman kind of froze up a little bit. I know that each and every one of you have a different store that pencils a car deal a different way. But if a customer asks you what's your interest rate, I want to tell you this. If they feel for 1 second, and just 1 second, that you're hiding something from them, they're gone, and it could turn the deal south even though it has nothing to do with you. During this video, I'm going to show you how to handle it and how that'll never be an issue for you ever again. Okay guys, so I'm going to go over this with you. I'm back at my desk because I want to show you what it looks like as you're actually sitting down and negotiating a deal. And by the way, anytime that I negotiate with somebody, I never do it across the desk, okay? So I'm always here and I'm knee to knee with my customer, and when I do that, actually, I always have a rule, and I kind of say this, it's kind of like in football. If you can touch it, you can catch it, right? If a receiver is going down the field and the quarterback throws the ball and it can touch his fingers, he was capable to catch that football, okay? If it was overthrown, that's fine. But if it can touch his hand, he can catch it. So my goal is that if I can put my arms around somebody, and I mean arm's length, right? If I can put my arms around them, I can close them and I can change the way that they think. So I will position myself when I'm delivering my pencil, no matter where I'm at, okay? And I get that it's coronavirus. Some of you guys are like, hey, Andy, this is weird. Look, you've been riding in the car with him the whole time, okay? If you're gonna get something, you already got it. So I'm just making a point. Whatever it is that you're doing, get the closer you can get during closing, the better, okay? And I know that that's off topic, but I want you to understand it has nothing to do with interest rates. I think that's just a good time to bring that out to you so you understand it. All right, so guy says, hey Andy, what is my interest rate? At that point in time, you can either flinch, you can make an eye movement where I do this. I honestly don't know that part. Do you see that? Did you see how for a second I looked away, I swallowed, right? And then I was about to tell you something. You don't believe me already. No matter what it is I say, you're not gonna buy in. Look, how about the truth of it is that look, most managers, when they pencil a deal, okay, they may disclose price, they may disclose payment, they may disclose even term, all of those numbers, but they don't normally disclose interest rate. Now, let's say your store doesn't disclose interest rate. I'm going to tell you how to get over it. But let's say your store does disclose interest rate. What if someone says, hey, I got a better rate than that on my last car? Well, what do you say then? This video is applicable for everybody. So number one, when someone says, Andy, what am I getting? What is my interest rate? What am I paying here for interest? Just say, hey, listen, I'm not a licensed finance professional, okay? So they don't go over that stuff with me, but I will tell you this. We're always high in the critical areas that are important to you and your family. But when it comes to the finance end, a licensed finance professional will go over that with you. But we have never had one person in the lifetime that I've been here walk out of finance because they didn't get the rate that they deserve. If you have great credit, you'll get a great rate. If you have good credit, you'll get a good rate. And then if you have bad credit, well, it'll just be that. And that's the way that credit works, because credit is how your rate is reflected. So with that being said, we base all of this off a money factor. But when you go back to finance will go over the rate with you. And like I said, we've never had somebody walk out of finance. I'm just not a licensed finance professional to go over that with you. That's it. And say, and back to the deal, who is going to be the first person you're going to show your new car to after you purchase it? What is it that, is there any other questions that I can give you as far as before we proceed with the deal? However you handle it, it's completely up to you. But the interest rate part of the deal is normally a concern. It's a stall. And as long as you don't show concern to it, the customer will advance themselves past it and they'll move on with the deal. So somebody says, hey, what's my rate? Look at them in the eyes, give them eye contact, and say, hey, that's a great question. I'm glad you asked. I'm actually not a finance professional. So I don't go to finance school. They don't go over that stuff with me. I actually don't even understand credit that great. I understand this part. If you have good credit, you get a good rate. Great credit, you get a great rate. And if you have bad credit, well, then that's just what it is. And obviously, at the end of the day, you'll get a great credit, or you'll get a great rate based on the way that your credit is. So our finance department has never had anybody walk out of the finance department before over interest rate. Okay? It's actually one of the best things that we're at in our store. So when you go back to finance, you can go over that with him, and then you guys can handle that. Cool? All right, awesome. Sign here, here, and here, and close them up. I just want you to understand this. There's going to be a million different places that we could talk about interest rate. Okay? There's going to be ways that, you know, a customer may have a problem with this, this, or this, and now they're asking about the rate, or they may be cool with everything, and now they're asking about the rate. If you just stick to what it is that I'm showing you, you will do very well. It will never be a problem. And 99% of the time, you will overcome it and allow your finance guy to handle that. Because how the deal is most of the time, the salesperson is in the middle to close a payment so that the finance guy can have a little leg and have a little bit of, maybe 2 points on his interest rate. You don't want to get into that. Let him handle that back there. Let him earn his money. Don't get into it, okay? And then at the end of the day, what if somebody says, and your boss does put the interest rate down and it says, hey, you know what, 4.99%, whoa, I got 2.99 on my last car. And let's say your manager does disclose it. Well, what you want to say on that deal is say, sir, I understand that. And look, obviously, your credit's as good as the way you pay your bills today. If you have the same credit as you had last time, this 4.99%, this is based off of what my finance manager told me to work the deal off of. At the end of the day, I don't talk to the banks. I don't submit stuff to the banks. So if you're happy with the deal, 4.99% is how we figured the payment. When you go back to finance, you can have that conversation with him. I'm not a licensed finance professional. And like I said, we've never had one person walk out of finance because they felt like they were paying too high of a rate. Okay? That's it. You handle it that way, this will never be a problem again. And the reason why I'm making this video is because I had a guy that said, hey Andy, I just had a big deal. The guy asked me what the interest rate was, and guess what happened? I got a little bit nervous, and he was trying to defend something and get nervous about something that it's not his job to defend. So had he just said it with confidence and handled it right, it would have never been an issue. I hope this video helps you guys. And like I said, when that objection comes up, memorize what I just said. It'll never be an issue for you again. Hey guys, I just want to tell you, thank you for watching the full video. I started when I was 18 training just like you. No matter where you're at in life, I want to tell you this. Being committed is all that it takes. I put out free training content on YouTube every single day to make sure that I can take you to the next level of life. I have over 500 free videos. Please make sure that you like the video. Shoot me a comment below and shoot me a text message. I'd love to get to know you, okay? If I haven't met you yet, 918-210-0254. Take a second, guys. Shoot me a text message. You're important to me. I have your back for life. We're going to go all the way to the top together. I appreciate you. You guys have a blessed day. Make sure you like the video, subscribe, and set your alerts for the daily training video. Thank you.